Thunder and UWS Giants. Ed Cowlishaw's my name, joining commentary by Josh Sampson. And Josh, the Thunder in complete control, 10-goal quarter as the scores just momentarily disappear for the moment, but a 10-goal quarter in complete control, 13-6-86 to the likes of the UWS Giants, 5-2-32. I tell you what, it had everything in that second quarter. High-flying marks, some great skills from both teams, really. But the Thunder just dominant from the centre clearances.
Yeah, they certainly were. And welcome back to everyone here on Tats Thunder Vision. And as Edo mentioned, a 10-goal third quarter from the Thunder. And at times, the ball movement, the use, and the shots on goal were just truly breathtaking. And they really did blow this game, this contest open in that second quarter. So it'd be interesting to see if the Giants can respond. And they did get the last couple late on, so perhaps let's see if they can continue that momentum going into this third term.
So players just getting into their positions, and no real injuries as per se so far in this match, which has been really good so far. Not to say that the players haven't been going hard at it, but it's always good to report that no one's been injured so far. Knock on wood. So as the umpire holds the ball aloft, and we get underway for the third quarter here at TIO Stadium in this cross-conference battle between the East and the North. And, well, another interesting bounce as Tyrrell taps it down to Rozier. He's heavily tackled, but the umpire will come in and ball it up yet again. All players still in their positions. No vacant forward 50s as yet, which we saw quite a bit of in that second quarter. So the umpire comes in. Ooh, awkward-looking bounce. Doesn't want to recall it, so he lets play go on. Vassell out to Rozier, linking up with Argus. This is Matthew. A sort of topsy-turvy up-country pick into the forward 50, but outmarked that time was Willie Farrah, there by the likes of Tim Golds, and he goes on to the outer side, linking up brilliantly there with Aylett. And slowly, they build it up along the wing. Nice penetrating kick there by Ugel, but is to no avail, and Damian Williams Jr. He takes on everyone, twists and turns his way out of trouble, heads back in the Ugel direction, another fine mark taken as well. So here come UWS.
Oh.
Under a little bit of pressure there by Gurawea, and Gurawea hand passes off, trying to link up now. Here comes Aylett, under a bit of pressure at the moment, it's perceived so far. Now there is actual black shirts in the way. They weave and wind their way out of traffic. Two-on-one situation, and a nice mark taken there by Kenrick Tyrrell on the outer side. So Kenrick Tyrrell, the ruckman for the NT Thunder, been a bit aggressive tonight, but that's what we expect from the big fella. As he goes back from whence it came, Matthew Argus on the bottom of this one. Fine mark taken there that time there by Bradley Vassell. He's heading over into Jed Anderson direction. Put two bites of the cherry on it. Didn't get it in that instance. He keeps the ball alive, keeps his feet on it as well. Gets it out, taps it forward, trying to find his partner in crime in Matthew Argus. Anderson goes in yet again, and it's UWS that trying to clear it along the scoreboard wing. Kenrick Tyrrell in, accompanied there by Phillips. A toe poke there for the Giants, and this could be trouble here for the Thunder. Great tackle there by Patrick Keenan. He should get the free kick for it. Nonetheless, though, it ends up in the hands of what it seems to be Smith. He does, and he gets pinged for it. Durke sleeks away and gets the first goal of the game.
It
hit the post. So that is poster number 5 so far. So an errant sort of beginning here of the third quarter.
Certainly been a big target for both sides tonight as Ben Rioli thumping kick. Jeez, what a great kick that was in the end to find Tyrrell. Kendi Tyrrell now. Well, it's 1-2 over to you. It goes back to Benny Rioli. So Rioli looking to bring it grandstand side now. He's got Dignan here and he's also got Heenan, and he finds the ladder. Good mark there in front of Roy Asan. Heenan now pumps it up the line. Good kick, and he finds our man, Nathan Brown, the weapon. Searching kick. Jeez, he was looking for Lockie Argus in the end to find Stuart Turner. A good kick into the middle, and he finds the likes of Stephen Clifton. Clifton now handballs it over the top. He looking there for Daly, I think it was. Has to go sideways, give up a bit of ground. Golds now handballs over the top. The Giants looking to work it away here. That's a good kick in the end. Oh, jeez, but swallowing it. Or should have swallowed it, I should say. There was Adam Tomlinson. Jeez, he's had a bit of a dirty night grabbing hold of the ball as the ball goes out for a boundary throw in grandstand centre wing side.
He went through the whole digestion process that time. He swallowed it and came out the other end.
He did.
Oh, well, Tomlinson having a dirty night up forward at the moment as Tyrrell taps it down, probably used his hands to push out and holding on, in fact.
Mm.
And a free kick will go the way of the number 42 in Mark Wiley. A likely type the sheriff, putting himself in there, and an errant fist as well, just copping it for his trouble. So this time, Tomlinson. Nice looking kick. And good work there by Verncombe. Oh, he just got a quick kick away. No one in particular trying to trap it this time. Whoa. Is Tim Colts. He misses it altogether, and away goes Jake Dignan. He puts it into the ascendancy. Lachlan Argus in the area. Same there with Darren Ewing. And it's a foot race between two. He keeps the ball alive. He's got plenty of time. He just needs some poise. He bounces on through for a behind. So Darren Ewing's woes in front of goals continue. And it's another behind on the board. So 87 playing 33.
So opportunity missed there from Ewing. Probably a little bit more time than he realised. Coming away with it now is Kennedy. Kennedy, geez, he takes the big fella on. He has a bounce. He's still streaking his way through. Nobody coming at him. A chip up the line. Good spoil there by Williams Jr. A free kick's picked out, and it's Wilson who drives the Giants forward. A high up and under sort of kick. Kenrick Tyrrell there to mop it up for Thunder. Verncombe now works it away, and Mr. Spreadable, he's having another great touch. Tavis Perry gets the ball now. Haven't seen a lot of him tonight, but doing the usual solid work that he does. Argus sees some good gut running through the lines there. Sells a bit of candy, handballs over to the sheriff in Lawler. Geez, there's some good movement here happening from Thunder. Farrell, oh, geez. That almost butchers it in the end. Wharton now brings it away for the Giants. Gets his own ball back in the end. Flanked there by the sheriff. Going up the line is the weapon. Oh, geez, he's just himself a little bit of collateral damage in the end.
Oh, weapon.
And center wing grandstand side, the Morris Rioli grandstand, the ball will be thrown in.
I heard the water pistol in that one,
oh,
I think.
He
won't be happy with that. He's a tough hombre, though, the weapon, in Nathan Brown. Look at the jukes, the cannons. Oh, he's feeling it a bit, though, at the moment.
Yeah, he works out. There's no doubt about it.
As the ball is thrown in. Ah, oh, geez. As we play on quickly, and UWS trying to trap it this time through Turner. He got himself out of it to Bunteen. Back to Turner, trying to get a quick kick away, but it's to no one in particular. And guess where it ended up? Back from whence it came, over the boundary line. And it will be thrown in just near the interchange. As Kenrick Curell comes off for a breather, and young Pryor comes on, the man from Alice Springs. And just trying to cement himself a spot in this side, which is destined to play finals at this stage. Only a couple of rounds to go. Tapped down by Pryor, only to the avail of Darley. Darley snaps on his right. Jeez, plenty of black shirts underneath this one. Thunder all over the place. Cossack gets it out, but it's Shark there that time. Great work there by Kintari. Tries to work it from outside 50. Got it onto the side of the boot. Durkay's going to have to work hard for it. Oh, geez, got the leg break that he desired. Durkay misjudged it, though, in the end. And it's the Thunder to clear through Rioli. So Rioli on the outer side. Used the outside of his boot to keep Wosley Black in tow. But here comes the likes. This time, who it seems to be, Duncan. He hand passes backwards to go forwards. And, well, they're waxing lyrical yet again here, the Thunder. Lining up for it. Take your time now, Lachlan Argus, because this is yours to roost on through for a behind. He's not happy about it, the number 13. So they've started slowly again. Maybe it's this end of the ground, Josh.
Could be.
You
could
never
be.
Know.
Yes. So 7 minutes gone here. Oh, geez, falling in behind there of Heenan was Tomlinson. But picking up the crumbs here is Anderson. Anderson tries to assess his options. That's a lovely kick for Mr. Spreadable. Has to sort of juggle his own ball. Handballs over the top to the weapon, who handballs sideways to Paddy Heenan. And from about 20 metres out, the check side kick goes bang, bang, bang right through the middle. And dare I say that, though, but the slaying of the Giants continues here at TIO Stadium.
Jack and the Beanstalk. It just brings back memories from the Storks about to be chopped off at the end. Those beans caused a lot of trouble for that young man. That's all I can say. I mean, we're seeing movies being created at the moment from these old nursery rhymes, and I'm just waiting for the Jack and the Beanstalk story just to turn up out of nowhere. And at the moment, Jack is having his flavour with it here at TIO Stadium. 14-10, 94 to 5-3. 33. Patrick Heenan, again, another midfield defender who's popping up in the right spots at the right time. And this is where the attacking flair of the Thunder can really hurt you on all lines of the ground. So the ball's back in the middle, and as the crowd just gets their chant up and under again, Pryor trying to tap it to the ascendance there of the NT Thunder. Jeez, they should have gone backwards to go forward. Poor old Paul Green in a bit of bother. Anderson tried to get cleaned up by his own man. Brown, a tap, tap, tippity tap, tap, tap footy there by the NT Thunder. Paul Green, a little man, jumps up. Bursting through the pack there is Smith. Great little pickup. Oh, maybe being held, and the umpire has deemed that. So Kieran Smith the number 34 for the NT Thunder, looking for some space. Dignan coming out a full forward at the moment, trying to get a touch, and, well, G. Smith didn't know what to do with it in the end. Dignan has ended up with it. He started in the goal square, and he's ended up with it on the centre-half forward line. Geez, has to be good with it, and a fine mark taken there by Tavis Perry. Could be 50 metres. Could be 50 metres. No, it isn't. And, well, the big gun, as you've dubbed him. Now, which part of the body is the big gun? Is it the leg? Is it the arms? What is it? Or is it just his all-round physique?
I think he's just the complete package.
The
complete package. You know, who needs a weapon sometimes when you do have a big gun, and he's got a chance to put one through for Thunder.
So Tavis Perry from just inside 50 kicks through the motion. That's number six for the night, that poster.
Somebody
number six.
The target.
Unbelievable. Where's Lou's handball when you need it? And, well, GWS will be kicking in, and they get some more reprieve, so to speak.
So 9.5 going here at TIO. Thunder leading it by 62 points as the ball goes up towards the outer side. Geez, copping a bit of flack there was Andrew Phillips, and he was deemed to be held onto. Moves it on quickly now. Scoreboard side, the brand spanking new video screen. And the ball goes out for a boundary throw in right in front of it, in front of the impact sign.
Interesting there. Tomlinson was goal side of Duncan there at that stage, just looking a little bit one kick forward. And I tell you what, they were on for young and old that time as the big gun comes off for a break, and Bradley Vassell comes back on.
So the ball thrown in now. Downey back into the ruck. So too is Thrice. A shallow throw in the end, but one down by Pryor. Anderson throws it on the boot towards centre-half forward. Coming out to meet it over, running it there was Farrah. Oh, geez, but running it over the top there also was Phillips. And it's a little bit hot in there at the moment. People throwing themselves in all over the place. Dignan extracts the ball out. Handball sideways to Wosley Black. Wosley Black with the green machines on.
Wosley
throws it on the boot. It's coming back. It's coming back. It's another poster.
Lucky number seven.
Lucky number seven. And Thunder move along to 14-12-96. UWS 5-3-33, almost 11 gone here at TIO.
That's in total for the night. It's not just the Thunder hitting the woodwork at the moment, but it's 6-1 in that regard.
It is.
So as the UWS Giants, this time through Daly, onto the outer side, a little punch away there, that time there by Pryor, but it's UWS, they keep the ball in play. It's one-on-one footy at the moment, trying to get his spot there is Ben Rioli. Oh, geez, tapped it to his owner, well, pretty much area, kept it going, Damian Williams Jr., and away they go, loping out of defence, had to beat two there, Anderson, did it with aplomb, over the top, and away go the Thunder. It's the Sheriff in Jack Lawler. He pops it up. Ewing goes up, keeps it alive, tapped it to his attendants, and he's marked into goal square. And this is the skills of this man. He may not have the height, but he's got the prowess, and he just goes plop and pops it through for another one. The NT Thunder break the ton. And, well, they just keep scooting along with it. Only 11 minutes 20 here gone in this third quarter. And, well, the premiership quarter, well, it's pretty much all theirs, really.
It is. I thought in the end it was a good kick from Farrah. Would have had the journey. I wondered if maybe Big Buff Ewing was going to shepherd it through. But, look, he's had a bit of a quiet night so far, and you've got to get them where you've got to take them sometimes. So a chance now for Thunder to really start to blow this open and get some percentage behind them.
So ball back in the middle as, well, we just strike 12, so to speak, in the minute mark here in this quarter. Quick hands there by Sampson in the commentary box just to keep the ball and bottle and water bottles alive so the equipment doesn't get battled. But here comes Rosier nonetheless. A high up and under kick falls to Ewing. He has to beat two or three of them. Great work there by Clifton to get the ball out of trouble. Geez, Redfern's in a bit of bother. Same with Daly, but it gets across anyway. Wait for it that time. There was Wiley. Great work there by Dignan. His attack on the ball was ferocious. Nathan Brown, little stab kick. Easy as you like to Mr. Spreadable. And, well, Chris Dunn will be lining up from 25 metres out, and he's definitely been the most accurate of kicks tonight. He's got three next to his name, also a victim of woodwork. So he's copped a couple of splinters in his time as well with the ball tonight. As he slots that one through, slices it like a dice, and another one on the scoreboard there for the Thunder. And 16-12-108 to UWS 5-3-33. And it's just happening in punches at the moment here for the Thunder. Probably a group of five goals, then UWS get a goal, and then another group five. That's how it's working at the moment. And the reason for that is the clearance work by the Thunder boys.
Yeah, it is. They're absolutely dominating out of the middle, no doubt about that. Jaden Pryor's been sensational in the ruck. Kenny Tyrrell's been very good in the ruck as well. I got to say, yeah, he's battled manfully all night, hasn't he, Andrew Phillips? Mm. But when you're going up against two monsters like Jaden Pryor and Kenny Tyrrell, you're always in for a tough night. So the umpire now bounces the ball down. Tyrrell is back in the ruck. Picking up the crumbs there, though, is Sam Darley. Handballs over the top to Durkay. Nice chip up the line in the end, and he finds Redfern. Redfern can now pump it inside 54, the Giants. He's looking for Roy Asano. Oh, knocked down well there was Duncan. Coming in also over the back there is Benny Rioli. They've got some numbers here on the grandstand side. Tavis Perry is one of them. Comes and meets the ball now. Waits for... Oh, geez, a little bit of shake and bake, if you don't mind. And a good kick in the end, and he finds the weapon, who's just wandered down from outside the forward half. Goes over the top and finds Wasley Black, who was put it through for poster number 7, as we called before. High, up and under sort of kick. Argus has got to go here, but coming over the back, the brotherly love linking up again. Well played, though, in the end by Kennedy. Good tackle by Matty Argus. Holds it up nicely. The umpire's having a look. What's he going to do? It is holding the ball. You are dead to rights, son. And the Thunder win a free kick about 65 metres out from their goal. They've congested it a little bit here, have the Giants in the Thunder's forward 50.
Kenrick Tyrrell's done his hamstring. He's off for the rest of the match. Saw him smashing the turf there before.
Yeah. Disappointing for the big fella. So Argus pumps it up towards the hotspot. Jumping from about three deep. He's done. Almost takes the mark. Dignan throws it on the boot. And it sails majestically through for another goal for Thunder. And doing just his usual solid, serviceable work, as he so often does. Popping up with a goal. And Thunder 17-12, 114, leading the UWS Giants 5-3-33. And Edo, that's really disappointing for the big fella and Kenny Tyrrell, isn't it?
It's more than disappointing. I'm thinking more about the club now and their journey towards the finals. This whether it's a serious one or not, but I just saw him. It looked like a little niggle. And when it comes to hamstrings and footballers, they're like paper cuts. They're the most annoying injury because you can't do anything but rest for them, and they can happen anywhere. It's like a bullet just hitting you in the back of the thigh. He wasn't too happy about it when he went off, so thoughts out there to Kenny Tyrrell and the Thunder coaching staff to try and find another ruckman. Let's see what Pryor can do in the last couple of, well, quarters out of this match. So it's ping-ponging around at the moment. A good work there by the weapon, the jet in Patrick Heenan. Sublime skills, and he blazes away and puts it through for a behind. Just probably had a little bit more time than what he thought. So ball to be kicked in here by UWS as the score reads 115-33. And another huddle starting to create. And only a couple of players in the forward half there for UWS as they come along the Morris Rioli grandstand. Duncan taps it out, finds the weapon, that time in Nathan Brown. Dignan keeps his space, but it's Mr. Spreadable! Oh, spread me some butter and some toast, Chrissy Dunn! That was absolutely vintage football there by the supreme half forward. And he's popped through at number 5 for tonight. And geez, he's just really in the right place at the right time, wherever you are on the ground.
It's just one of those nights, isn't it? Everything he seems to touch goes through for a goal, and he is having a wonderful night indeed. And interesting there, he looks like he's trotting back into the middle. So Daniel Archer rotating some of the Mosquito fleet heavily through that midfield zone, and as the weapon has a chat with runner Wally Gallio there, looks like he might be coming off as well for a rotation. Jed Anderson back on. So the Rocks now going at it again. It's Phillips up against Pryor. Pryor wins the tap down. Tackling there. Good tackle on the top of Pryor. Also, I should say, Rosier. Durkay now kicks it away up the line. Good kick, and he finds Redfern, who's been good in this third quarter. He goes up to Kennedy, who pumps it inside 50. A good spall coming over the top there was Verncombe. Throwing it on the boot up towards the forward line was Aylett. One out in the goal square between Kintari and Benny Rioli. Benny Rioli winning it out for a rush behind. So the Giants can move along now to 5-4-34, the Thunder 18-13-121.
Damian Williams Jr. just chips it across there to the Sheriff and Jack Lawler. So Lawler looking for options, and there's plenty of them at the moment. Willie Cossack, we know he can fly like a bird and sting like a bee. Moves it across there to Verncombe. Anderson, an option here just on the wing. He sort of mongrels it up along the line here. Great work there by Turner to try and create some space for his fellow opponents. Geez, plenty of players around a scrimmage here. Vassal's in attendance. Also, there's Asani put his head over the ball. Players spilling like nine pins at the moment as it scoots over the boundary line for touch right in front of the Thunder interchange, and it will be thrown in. So a lot of players still putting their bodies on the line, which is great to see. You can see games like this just peter out into nothing, yep. Sort of circle work, so to speak. But both teams still putting their bodies on the line as Phillips doing ruck work there with Pryor. Smith outgunned there that time there by the likes of Daly, and he's seen it over the boundary line. Tried to kick for touch and put the check side in as well, but it's to no avail. And interesting, I would have thought that was out of bounds on the full, Josh.
Looks like it might have been off hands in the end, a smothered kick. So a lucky one there for Sam Daly, because it was an awful kick.
Very, very cool. Wow. Hard hitting and straight to the point. Josh Sampson, Test Thunder Vision. That's how we love him. So ball goes up yet again. Phillips doing the ruck work. He's done well in the hit-outs tonight. Under pressure there is Kintari. Gets it out to the likes of Tavis Perry. Jumping on the ball on a free kick. Going the way of Jake Dignan, it looks to be. That's his fifth for the night, free kicks. Really does put his head in the right position to get them, and that's called courage. As he goes on to the outer side, looking for Damian Williams Jr., had a great under-18 Nationals Championships. Finds his partner in crime in Ben Rioli, and now the weapon's got the ball on the outer side. Nathan Brown, Williams Jr. kept running, lost the handle on the ball, back to Nathan Brown. He chip kicks it, unfortunately it goes to an orange shirt. And that time, it is the number in Downey. Onto the outer side, moves it quickly. And then it's Durke. So Durke is marked in front of our old temporary scoreboard. Puts it high, up in the air. And a fine mark, great mark indeed, taken there by the likes of Phillips. So Phillips on the outer side. Oh, geez, he might fancy himself here. He's popped it up in the right position to the hot spot. Anyone underneath it, and a fine mark has been taken. It looks like it's Kintari.
No, it's Roy Asan.
Oh, Roy. Well, that was a brilliant mark indeed. Oh, he plays on quickly. He does it as easy as you like. Just chips it over the top there, a little snapshot. And another goal on the board there for UWS. And that's their first this quarter, and that's their sixth in the game.
Opportunist goal there indeed from Roy Asan. Nicely judged. He saw it, he jumped for it, and he clunked it, and then went back and I thought rather lackadaisically almost put it through. But no, great answering goal there from the Giants again. It's that point of the match where they needed one, ticking into red time here in the third quarter as the ball now coming back in the middle. And mentioned it a few times, geez, Andrew Phillips, he looks like he's really starting to feel the pinch coming up against the bigger, harder bodies. And The slightly warm conditions. Some people in the territory think it's freezing cold, but that's a story for another time. Geez, interesting there. Wosley Black up in the ruck against Phillips. And the ball will be bounced pretty much from where it started.
Well, he's got the height to do it in the ruck as well, so it'll be interesting to see what the kid's like.
So, take two, and Wosley Black jostling for position there with Phillips. Nobody really wins the tap out. Oh, geez, copping one high was Paddy Heenan, and he will take the free kick. Now looks to assess his options again. Good searching kick for Anderson. Good hands by the young fella. Handballs, plays on quickly. Tavis Perry throws it on the left boot up towards the full forward line. But well judged in the end, it must be said, by Jack Homsch. And Homsch now looking to play on quickly. Handballs over the top to Golds. Golds now switches the play towards the outer side of the ground. It's a lovely kick finding Tyrese Durkay in the end. But where to from here is the question. The Giants have got no room inside their forward 50. Good searching kick.
Finds Paul Green. Hey?
Finds Josh Heath's love child in Paul Green. So the Giants again now playing on quickly. It looks like it's Barra up against, looks like it was Willie Cossack. And it was, in fact, it's Jackie Lawler. Oh, almost overcooking the ball there for Jake Dignan. He's got Perry in space. Or does he have him in space? Good punch over the top there from Clifton. Picking up the crumbs nicely was Nandu. Nandu now still scrapping in over the ball. Geez, they're throwing themselves in there, so players from both sides. Nandu throws it on. It's a hard one there for Asan, and in the end, the ball comes out back for the Thunder. Matiagas just back on for the Thunder. Takes the ball just outside the defensive 50. And again, bit of a press happening here. Oh, geez, he went to go up the line, and he ended up putting it 20 rows back just about. It's gone out of bounds on the full, the Giants, to take the free kick.
Interesting, he ignored his brother, and then he kicked it over his brother's head, out of bounds on the full. So, yeah, those roommates will be having a chat about that a little bit later on tonight, I reckon. So Turner Heads back in the Argus direction from where the ball came. And a fine mark taken there by Phillips. He's a really good likely prospect. Yeah. He looks like he might develop into something really special for GWS, their senior side, a little bit later on in the journey for the club and himself. So Phillips from outside 50, he'll probably kick right on the mark. The big giant of a ruckman. Good looking kick, just too much curl on that one. And it's through for another behind. So UWS, it is 6-5-41 to the NT Thunder, 8-13-121, and the Thunder move it quickly, and you've got runners all over the joint at the moment. Look at the running skills there of Willie Farrow. He plays on quickly, burning it like the midnight oil, and well, it's a bit slippery like that as well, as he hand passes backwards, goes to Kevin Verncombe. Nice little setup at the moment. Matty Argus trying to find some space. It's two in a row there for Matty Argus, two little fumbles. And, well, they've lost a handle on the ball here, the Thunder. Great tackling seen over the boundary line. So just probably kicking and decision-making when he shouldn't be at the moment, Matty Argus. Yep. And just probably needs to take a step back and take his time with the ball. So ball just to be thrown in, 60 metres out from the Thunder attacking 50 on the brand-new scoreboard wing. Still yet to be named. So as the ball is thrown up, a little bit of a curve on that one. Verncombe doing the ruck work that time. It's tapped over the top. The big gun in Tavis Perry tried to tap it on quickly again. Instead, it's the UWS Giants and Matty Rozier. Well, he would have dominated in a half-time display, wouldn't he, with catching that ball. He heads into the middle of the ground and makes Tavis Perry work hard for his money. Plays on quickly. Good work there by Smith. Linking up and missed the spreadable. Probably dropped what he could have taken that time. Play on quickly. He's going to chase down the tackler. He's got some support there from the weapon. Chris Dunn plays on quickly. Got some more support there by Lachlan Argus and missed the spreadable. Well, let's just put it this way. There were no crusts on his piece of bread when he started spreading. Out of bounds on the full. And it's gone everywhere. So it will be kicked in this time by the likes of Adam Kennedy. Deep in the back pocket. Finds the target in Clifton. Really good in the first quarter. Gone a bit quiet since then. Gone back from whence it came. And they're starting to link up on the outer side. So Kennedy got the handball out. Find Aylett. Aylett on the outer side. Tomlinson. Beautiful mark and lead. Finally digested that one. Popped it up and under. Heading in the area of the number 16, and that is Nathan Wilson. He's taken a fine mark, and they've gone the whole length of the ground, and they've done this on multiple occasions tonight. Obviously not enough, but they've made it look good, yep, nonetheless.
Yeah, a little bit of coast-to-coast footy there, using the outer side of the ground and just away a couple of really penetrating kicks. And before you know it, they're back inside 50.
So Nathan Wilson has got the Wacko Jacko glove on, all ready to go. Nice looking lead up into the kick and made the umpire work just a tad too hard, and he's pushed it to the left for a behind.
So almost 26 and a half minutes gone here at TIO Stadium, third term. Thunder leading it by, coming over the top there was Anderson, the big fella in Downey. Handball's looking for his Giants teammate. They're away here though through Kieran Smith. The Thunder has a bounce, kicks it quickly. Ewing gets a bit caught out of position there, and he did. It was nicely judged by Jack Homsch, who has done what is, must be said, is an outstanding job on the big fella this evening. So the Giants now looking to work your way again. Nice hands in the end from Joey Redfern in front of Lockie Argus. Not happy with himself, chastising himself, as it were. And the press is happening again here. Gets the wiggle on from the umpire. Drives it up towards the grandstand side. Jumping from behind. Good hands again. Jeez, he has wonderful jukes. The big fella in Andrew Phillips. Driving it inside 50. Great take in the end by Roy Asan. Dribbling it across the face. And again, probably had more lazy time than he realised. It was a bit lazy. And had probably a little bit more time than he realised. Could have even gone back and had the set shot, and Thunder will be looking to come away with it again.
Phillips has really come into his own since Tyrrell's gone off with that hamstring injury earlier on in this quarter. Is the Thunder quick attack now. Matty Rozier on the outer side, this time being guarded by the likes of Aylett. He moves it on quickly. Willie Farrow jumps before anyone's even thought the ball's going to come to him, and he chips it across to Lachlan Argus. Oh, drop what he should have taken. That was a lollipop, that one. And, well, he tries to fight for it to get it back. Matty Rozier put his body on the line, forces the contest. The weapon's in attendance as well. And that is the siren for three-quarter time. Hey, look, the game is done and dusted. There's no doubt about that at this stage. But I will say this, this is entertaining stuff nonetheless from both these sides. You've got UWS going coast to coast. There are dribbler goals. There are high-flying marks. And we want you to stay with us for another 30 minutes because it's going to be entertaining here on Tats Thunder Vision. 18:30, 121, a 79-point lead. The NT Thunder against the UWS Giants. 6-6-42. It's tight, it's tough, well, in the entertainment stakes anyway. And we'll be back in a couple of moments' time for the final quarter of this cross-conference.